will. Then I go to my brother. And I say, brother, help me please. But he winds up knocking me back down on my knees. Oh, there have been times that I thought I could last for long, but now I think I'm able to carry on. It's been a long time coming, but I know the change gon' come. Oh, yes it will.
Well, we are a few hours shy of 1 week when poor-month-old LaMelo was gunned down on I-10. And we still have no information with the exception of the fact that he was, in fact, shot once. And that he died as a result of that shot, according to the coroner. We still have no autopsy on Smith or on him. They have not been presented yet. Smith, the father of LaMelo, it said that he was shot several times. We don't know how many times that he was shot. He was, in fact, killed there, pronounced dead. LaMelo was taken to USA Medical Center, where later on, within hours, the next day, early morning hours, around 1 or so, he gave up his very young life of 4 months. And there's no explanation. And you reached out to the family there in Baton Rouge. What is being said there?
The family's reflecting back on what could have been, you know, warning signs. Not talked directly to them just yet. We are hoping to hear back from them sometime today.
Do you have a story? No?
Yes, I do. They were interviewed by a local station there in Louisiana. Here's what they had to say.
Father God, we cast all of our cares upon you, for you,
God.
Lord, touch this family, Lord God.
Family.
We pray, Lord God, for the children, Lord
prayer.
God. We pray a covering over them.
Those are the three things the Parker family are leaning on after this week's tragedy.
It's like a dream that I wish that would have never came true. Our dear sister, our dear brother.
Kristen Parker and her nephew Brandon were shot and killed inside their home in Baker Monday. Parker's 4-month-old son, LaMelo, also died after the suspect, Eric Smith, kidnapped him and led police on a chase that ended in a shootout. Parker's family is still in disbelief.
The next door neighbor came and said that Kristen dead. I say, no, Kristen ain't dead. I say, Kristen called me this morning, told me when I get out of work to stop by. I say, she said, go to the room, and she said, turn on the TV. And she said, it's all over the TV, Mama. So we went to the room, and we turned on the news, and that's when we saw.
To help us, Lord God.
Kristen leaves behind 4 kids, including one that was inside of the home when the shooting happened. The father of one of the boys told us they have a long road ahead of them.
I hope as time passes, he'll get stronger and stronger. But he got to do that through God and counseling. I told him it already, ain't no other way.
Their hope is that this situation will lead to a different type of conversation.
From this situation, it should open a lot of eyes to domestic violence.
Friends say they had a long history of domestic violence. One that dates back before baby LaMelo was even born.
She thought she could handle the situation on her own. You know, the more she could, you know, it was just too much. I mean, she had got to a point that she just didn't know what to do.
Johnny Williams says Parker feared for her and her kids' lives daily, and that Kristen at times felt helpless.
A lot of people say sprained arms, stuff like that. They know that don't stop.
That don't stop them. They know that.
Father God, we ask you right.
Pastor Robert Scott is a family friend and has known the Parkers for years. He hopes people will see this and have more talks about the help that's out there.
Get help now that this situation will not be your situation.
In Jesus' name we pray.
A friend, a co-worker, and most of all, a mother, they'll be missed by many.
Amen.
Walmart lost a great worker. The community lost a sweet and loving young lady. The children, which are now at loss with parent that loved them.
Hmm. So the mother, father, dead, and the younger brother, dead. And contrary to what the journalist said, LaMelo did not die. LaMelo was killed. And ladies and gentlemen, the children, as Jesse Jackson put it, children come in this world and they didn't ask to come here. And upon being here, all they can do is live. That's it. That's it. And regardless of what Smith did, the father or the mother, LaMelo's not life should have been considered here. And that lies squarely in the hands of law enforcement, as far as I'm concerned. Look, the police reports doesn't show much about Smith. If there were domestic situations, then it's not showing up on the record. But don't get me wrong, I don't doubt that it was. Because Christine, his girlfriend, now deceased, refused to allow LaMelo to have his last name. That spoke volumes to me. I didn't need to know that there was some domestic problem. Obviously, she did not trust this man and certainly didn't respect him enough to give the name. And, you know, I think that's the way it should be anyway, to be quite frank. Don't marry the woman, you don't get the name. Simple as that. By the way, I've been there. Don't act like I'm not acting like I'm some savior, some God's gift. You know, I'm perfect. No, I've been there. My daddy's been there. I had to be legitimized when I was born. He didn't marry my mama until I was 3. Love him just the same. But it wasn't a given that you just give the last name of the child to the father when the only thing he has done is indulged. Another topic for another day. I'm not letting this go, Chief Miller. We've reached out. And we have reached out to the DA. So what do you want, Rip Daniels? What I want is an explanation as to why those officers fired on that car. That's what I want. You have protocol in a hostage situation. If you didn't follow that protocol, admit it. That 9-month-old baby was in that car and you knew he was in that car. Black babies' lives matter. And for those of you who say, well, Smith shouldn't have brought that baby. Yeah, Smith, obviously, according to the older child who saw him. Although he's not been convicted of the crime of killing the nephew and his girlfriend, it was an eyewitness. Now, I don't know whether the eyewitness said that he saw him actually kill them, but saw him leave. Good enough for me. But both, there were 2 lives in that car. And I'm not going to fluff it off and say, okay, yeah, well, all right, yeah, well. There's no doubt that more than likely, the reason for this whole thing is because of the father. Gotcha. Understand? But under these circumstances whereby this Smith had become immobilized, and they're like a sitting duck, there was no reason to kill that baby. Now, you want to try to explain that away, you go right ahead. By the way, right now, Brianna now is being investigated by the feds, as it should be. Listen, in this country, we are free with our effects from each other. You understand what that means? That means that you don't have the right to take my life. You denied my freedom because you took my life. Government cannot just be allowed to do that. That's what happened in Brianna's case. That's what happened in LaMeadow's case. Oh, these are mitigating circumstances, blah, 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 blah. You can say that. This was deliberate. It was no accident. Well, that baby accidentally got shot. No, hell no. It didn't accident. The child didn't accidentally get shot, bro. There's a big old target right there. Wasn't going anywhere. Wasn't going anywhere. You can explain it away all you want. I'm waiting to hear what is the explanation. And then what's the policy? What's the repercussions behind this? Really and truthfully. It'd be wonderful if we were to hear something from law enforcement besides, well, we did our job. 4 months old baby was killed and we did our job. Bro, what do you want? What do you want? I want the truth. At the very least, the truth. And then own up to the fact that you shouldn't have fired that shot. You got to own up to that now. You got to own up to that. Look, there's a deer. Think I'll shoot it. What else is that over there behind the deer? I don't know, but I'm shooting this deer. What if you miss? Well, let God sort it out. That is not how we do policing. That is not how we deal with a civilized society here, folks. And we're allowing folks to get to do this because of some fear that you'll be seen as what? Critical of law enforcement? You ain't critical of law enforcement. You're critical of those individuals who made a snap judgment, motivated by whatever. I don't know. One thing, they made that judgment. As a result of it, it wasn't empathy. Certainly wasn't sympathy either. Maybe it was, I just want to go home to my kid. Screw all the other kids. Yeah, I know he's in there, but hey, look, I want to go home to my kids. Look, I didn't volunteer for this. This is my job, but I didn't volunteer to get out here and face no bullets. Really. Rip, you do it. I do it every day, homie. I do it every day. You can't get on the airways and do what I do and not face them crazies. And typically what will happen is, after the fact, I'll call you. Many of you know I have. You, the FBI, any one of my other friends. But that's only after I've handled it. I'm just making sure that you're in the loop. So we here on the coast and are very, very impatiently waiting for Chief Miller and the investigation there. The Biloxi PD is investigating because their professional officers did not fire a shot. No one on their team fired a shot. And it was literally in Biloxi where this happened. Kudos to you. It's not a put down on anyone else, by the way. Do I think that Smith should in fact have been killed as a result of his actions if in fact he was impairing or making dangerous, his actions? Do I think that? I think to defend yourself, absolutely. Well, I'm not a conscientious objector now. On the other hand, when you know that you've got someone cornered, you know, sort of like catch and release. Sort of. You know, once I've caught that big bass, I gotta decide whether I'm gonna eat it. If not, I'll let it go. Now you're not gonna release this individual, but you ask yourself, well, okay, so what is he gonna do? Flash his gun, sit there, what he's waiting for me to do, kill him as a cop. Now, I'm not going to accommodate you today. Well, he's just shooting right now. Well, what is he hitting? We all taking cover. Everybody's cool. If he comes out of that car without that baby, take him down. Who's got it? Smith? You're the sniper? Okay, y'all, Smith's got the red dot. Yeah, he's got the dot there, center mass. You can see it. Everybody can see it. It's a green dot. Oh, that's even better. You can see it. Okay, good. Smith's going to take the shot. Everybody else just be cool. Pow. All right. So you'll hear this every day until such time we have gotten some kind of conclusion on this. Besides, we killed the guy who allegedly killed his girlfriend and nephew. And what his actions did, what resulted in the death of his own 6-month-old. It was his actions, Rip. It was his actions. He shoot his own son? If he didn't shoot his own son, it's not his action. If he did shoot his own son, come on, show us the autopsy. Let's see this. Let's make sure of this. We heard that baby cry after Smith was shot multiple times. Louisiana trooper saw the child there and his dad is left. We've not seen the gun, not heard from the gun. I'm not saying one wasn't there. We've had no confirmation from law enforcement. No official confirmation that a shot was even fired. On several occasions, local journalists said, well, police said that there was a shot. We've not talked to any police who's confirmed that, bro. We've
not seen any reports to indicate that either.
The other thing is, regardless of whether there was a shot or not, what do you do in a hostage situation where you've got an assailant who's held up? I mean, we've gone through it on several occasions here. Several occasions, and on many occasions, it turned out right. You know, there was a situation, and I know that there are some relatives out there who are listening to this show who know what I'm talking about. I got a phone call one late evening. It was in close proximity, within a block of my house, where a young man was held up and swore that he was not going to go back to jail, not going to be taken alive, and he wasn't. Horrible situation. There was some negotiation. That's how they found out that he said he was not going to be taken alive. What do you do in that situation? Now, I don't fault the officer, and I don't doubt that that officer is... thinks about that situation, but he had to come up with a target, and he did. They're hard decisions, but the scrutiny in those hard decisions have to be there. It can't just be, I think so. It can't just be, is that a deer? Isn't that? Is brown like a deer? The only reason why I bring up a deer in this is because you guys seem to care more about animals than a 4-month-old sometimes. And those of you who are hunters who or habit hunters, you know what I'm talking about. You've got to know your target, and you got to make sure there's nothing else beyond that target. Nothing else beyond that target, like another hunter. All right. We'll fill you in as we get to it. We shall. We're in a very vulnerable place. Thanks to your generation, Ro, and a generation before that, and other generations who are just completely, adamantly dependent upon the Internet. I tell you, folks, you guys, I'm going to say right now it is time to declare that the Internet is another utility and therefore governed by utility authorities. It is time now, government. It's time for government oversight. Don't believe these wacko, crazy conservatives. Let the free market determine it. I'm in the free market. I'm in the free market, right? What we have now is not just a free market. We have a controlled market. It's controlled by monopolies, ladies and gentlemen. Now, probably now that Donald John is being banned from all of the major platforms, now they might even call for Internet being a utility. Of course, now they have to wait till after Biden goes out. But the point is that you have major companies now. Major companies who are controlling communication platforms. It's a serious, bro.
Very.
You know why the FCC was born, Federal Communications Commission was born? Let me tell you why. It was born primarily because mass communication began. I mean, you had Alexander Bell and several others came up with the whole idea of the lights, you know, all of that. And then a telegraph. And government, our government, realized that the way we keep this nation together is that we keep it, the nation informed. And at the time, it was telegraph. And then it became the telephone. And God knows, now we've got the internet. Now, these things that have some oversight, government oversight, and they should. What you're hearing now, this broadcast, right? Radio now, these are the airways. We went from the wire to now the airways. We're using frequency, and you can hear me. And then we went from frequency to digital now. I don't know how that works. You got the matrix and the this and the that, and then all of a sudden visibility, and you mix it with the frequency and all. I don't know how I get there, but I get there. All of it overseen by the FCC. Now, why am I saying this? I'm saying this because, ladies and gentlemen, for any of you who have ever gone through malware or have been hacked, you should know why. So now we have one of the largest oil pipelines that's been hacked, and they've shut down. First and foremost, I'm going to tell you, something like that should never be dependent upon Plan A. Look, folks, I've gone through recently, I think last year, it actually was last year, we went through this. We went through ransomware, the whole works, and, you know, it's really good. It's a good thing when you grow up in a business that teaches you redundancy. You know what that is? Redundancy is plan A, B, C, D. Actually, it wasn't just a business. I grew up that way with my parents, my mother and father. In that generation, the so-called great generation, they grew up with saving money for a rainy day because they knew one day it was going to rain. And they always had spare parts. And it was always a just in case. My daddy said that to me. Boy, I'm going to teach you how to be a cement finisher just in case. What you think you need to know doesn't work. God bless him.
What a lesson.
Yeah. So I became a contractor. So I come from that generation, well taught. Bro, your generation, it's just plan A. Plan B is throw it away and get another one.
Well, plan B is, why didn't plan A work? I want plan A to work so bad. And then we wait a little while. And then we go get another one.
We are too dependent. We're too dependent on the internet for it not to have some oversight here.
And, you know, it wouldn't be that big of a deal if infrastructure weren't dependent on it. If it was just us.
Yeah,
you know, we'd
right.
have redundancies. Oh, well, I'm going to check my bank. Oh, I can't get online and check my bank. Well, I can go to the bank. And they can tell me, right? Because whatever is online should also be on paper somewhere, right?
Right.
But
that's plan B.
That's plan B. And it's always been that plan B.
You're right? Plan C? Take a picture.
Take a picture of the picture. Write it down.
Fish, huh? I'm
take
serious.
A picture of it. Keep the negatives of the picture to make more pictures.
All right.
But... okay, that's great. You know, that's personal services. But when you talk about infrastructure, like you just mentioned, that starts to get super dicey because it's not just a singular person or a singular entity even that's going to be dependent. It's going to be massive. And if it's massive when it goes out, then the loss is massive.
Let me tell you why this is so important, ladies and gentlemen. You know wiretaps and so forth?
Mm-hmm.
Well, that has its origination based upon party lines.
Explain.
Well, you know, this is really before me, that someone before me can explain it a little better. I came along at the tail end of party lines. Party lines was when I called my Aunt Ruth over in New Orleans. Her number was Twin Brook 10966. Amazing, I remember that.
Wow.
Twinbrook 10966. Well, how do you put Twinbrook in the phone? Well, you don't. The operator will answer, and then you will say, I will say, Twinbrook is given the location. It breaks it down. Twinbrook 10966, I would say, as a 9-year-old, as I was getting on the Greyhound bus to go visit my aunt. Twinbrook 10966. Okay, sir. Twinbrook 10966. Click, click. And then all of a sudden the phone rings. Now, when the phone rings, she'd pick it up. And she'd answer, hello. And then I would respond. And then periodically, someone else would pick the phone up. Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't know you were on here. Because it's a party line. So the line that goes, it's going to ring there, but for whatever reason, and I don't understand why, the lines are either crossed or when someone else is on, someone else can pick up, and of course you were expected to be very considerate.
Other phones had access to the phone line.
And the operator had access then to whoever you were calling, and she could listen in. Which is why the FCC was so important to this. Privacy was at stake. I was paying for the line. Is that not the same thing as the internet? Just think about it. I mean, you're able to now hack into it without anyone knowing. You get the right, I don't know what they call the numbers, whatever the phone number is, the address of blah, 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 blah. Someone gets your password and they can go in and do all your stuff.
IP address.
It's against the law. No, really. It's against the law. And the authority, investigative authority, is going to be the Federal Communications Commission. They're the ones who broke up Ma Bell. You don't know about Ma Bell. Ma Bell, at one time, all the telephones, all everything was long distance, the telephones, the wires, everything was owned by Ma Bell. And by way of the antitrust laws, suits were filed, and they found out they were too big. It's really too big to fail. And the courts ordered Ma Bell to break up. That's how you ended up with all these different other kinds of subordinate telephone companies. And never again were they supposed to ever come together and control that much wire, that much. I mean, they had to control of everything, long distance and so forth. After then you had long distance companies come in. I think the same thing's got to happen with the internet. Why am I saying this? Because we just had a pipeline get malware. Pipeline doesn't come up. I'm going to tell you something. There will be $4, maybe even $5 gas. And that combined with the fact that there could be also a maneuver on the part of the gas company to jack the price. I'm just saying. Now, look, these folks have more money than God. God doesn't need any money. You know what I'm saying to you? And so there has to be some oversight, bro. Who's going to tell, what's his name, the Farnberg or whatever his name over Facebook?
Zuckerberg.
I mean, who's going to tell these guys what to do? Who's going to say, okay, is it really? Like, for instance, you go on Facebook and they say you got this much reach. How do you know? Well, they told me so. The Google Analytics. Well, who's this guy Google? Well, Google. You know Google. You just trust this? There's got to be some committee of individuals just like me who don't know what the heck how this works, but know what the rights of people are. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
To say no, this is not good for society. This is not good for the public.
Right.
What you doing here?
Right.
You can't put porn on. Not this time of day. No. We got too many folks. And so now, here we are sitting ducks, dependent upon this business. I said it's a business, Colonial Oil, whatever, to get it back working again, or they're going to have to pay mail. Do you know that New Orleans was hit with malware?
Yep.
Two large communication companies there, radio and TV, was hit with malware. One of which, I think New Orleans actually decided to pay, and then they got hit again. I was instructed not to pay. I did not. But what I had was Plan B and C. Remember that, Ro?
Oh, yeah.
You guys may not have known it. Well, you may have seen some glitches here and there. We went back to analog. I would have started spinning music here for us all over, Ro.
Gotta have a backup plan.
8-track tape was going. I'm not throwing anything away. Talk about A, B, C, D. I'm telling you, it was like, okay, well, what are we going to do now? Well, the transmitter, we've got to get the CCA going, another tube type, get a bunch of rats running on coil. So anyway, I thought that, look, we're in very bad shape. Yeah. Because, look, listen to me, your Social Security check is dependent upon this. Do you realize that? Here we are depending on, we're depending on the AT&T company. Who is it, Cable One? Who is it? AT&T? Who is it? We got Verizon this month? Well, we changed administration, so we're going to go with Verizon. They're providing, I don't know whether this is true or not, but they're providing the internet access to your information for you to get your check. Well, the internet went down. You can't do this. America, you can't do this. You can't do this. Now, that doesn't mean you've got to go back to the Pony Express. But there's nothing wrong with keeping horses just in case now, Ro.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm just saying. All right, I know we're all over the board here, folks. Got a whole lot to share with you. Boy, yesterday was a grand day for moms. Mm-mm-mm. If you missed the cruise, boy, you missed it. Big announcement. Big announcement. There's going to be a Father's Day cruise. Be looking for it. Ticket's going to go on sale very, very soon. It's going to be hot, too. Man, those mothers just wore that boat out. It was dancing all up and down that boat, though.
It's a good thing.
A champagne brunch, they felt no pain. That was my own mixture of champagne, too, by the way. So it's like a mimosa plus.
Oh.
Good, too, wasn't it? All right, quick break, folks. We're going to get caught up on all the stuff that happened over the weekend. And Mississippi now has a dubious distinction of being number one. Number one. I'll tell you where when we come back.